and Brad, the two most famous physical therapists on the internet.
Hi, folks, I'm Bob Schrupp, physical therapist.
Brad Hanick, physical therapist.
Together, we are the most famous physical therapists on the internet.
In our opinion, of course, Bob.
This video today was put together by Mike and Alex of the Bob and Brad crew.
Mm-hmm.
Both are physical therapist assistants, and both have been providing treatments to our patients for years. They do
fantastic work.
Fantastic work.
We're very happy with all the work with their patients. We have reviewed and approved all of their material that they're bringing up. So they're showing you our treatment through them with their experience, and it's been
a
wonderful.
So make sure you subscribe to the Bob and Brad Crew channel, in which they do reviews of products that keep you healthy, fit, and pain-free. They handle all of our new products now. Enjoy the video.
Good luck.
Hello, everyone. I'm Alex, physical therapist assistant.
I'm Mike, physical therapist assistant.
And this is the Total Hip Replacement Fitness Program, exercises 0 to 4 weeks after surgery, so about a month out after surgery. Four goals, again, in this time of your life. Number one, pain control. Continue with your medication, you know, if you think you need it. Take your pain meds about 1 hour prior to exercise to, you know, maximize your results during exercise.
The next goal, number two, is to work on your swelling management. You want to prevent any blood clots from forming and continue to monitor your incision. You can rest, ice, compress, elevate, still the Rice principle.
Yep.
Just do those things and get your swelling under control.
Let pain be your guide, they say. Number three, continue following your restrictions. You know, whether you had a posterior approach or an anterior approach, your surgeon will tell you that. But we want to avoid, you know, a dislocation. I think it's worth saying it does not happen often, but
it can happen.
You said you've heard of it, so.
Goal number four is keep progressing your range of motion with this video. Also working on your strengthening of your hip and your leg, and work on your walking or gait quality.
Yep, your range of motion within your restrictions, and we're going to get into that.
Yeah.
So we don't have to say, you know, one set of 10 throughout all these. Start with one set of 10. Increase your reps and your sets as able with all these exercises.
Yep.
And you said last video, you don't have to do them all. You know, there's 13 exercises here. Don't do them all at one time. You know, break them up. And you might be able to pick and choose which ones you need to do at this time.
If you're early on, week 0 to 1, go through exercises 1 through 6 more. 7 through 13 are more for the later weeks.
Yep, so. Exactly. So we're going to get it. I'm going to get in a chair out of Mike's way here. He's going to start by
take a nap again.
Laying down.
Number one is ankle pumps.
I'm younger than him, too, by the way, so I'll let
him
lay
down. You aged more, though. You have kids.
Easy. Yeah, that is true. I can't deny that.
Okay, pumping my ankles up and down. Alex is probably doing more calf toe raises.
Calf toe raises, same thing.
Do them anyway. Sometimes I like doing these in general when I wake up in the morning, but that's just me.
And again, Mike, you could elevate your legs on some pillows and do ankle pumps. Would probably get a little swelling out of there a little faster, but just an option.
As long as you're press your precaution range, it's fine to do that.
Yep. Number two, glute sets, squeezing your butt cheeks together.
These ones hold for 5 seconds. Try to at least, you can go up to 10 seconds if you can handle it, but.
I just squeezed it and I thought I was going to fly off the chair there for a second. Glutes of steel.
I thought you were talking about passing gas there.
Well, that too. All right, number three, quad sets. Michael demonstrate as he's laying down here.
So this one, again, you're going to push the back of your knee into the mat, activate your quads. So this one, again, hold for 5 seconds if you can. 4,000, 5,000, relax. Try to do 10 sets of it. Not too complicated. It's in our previous video as well.
Yep. Number four, laying on your back, bringing your heel in and out, hip abduction, adduction.
Yep, so going out and in. Try to keep your toes pointed towards the ceiling. Depending on your approach, you're not supposed to rotate in or out too
far. That's a very good point, Michael.
So keep your toe up. Yes. Also, when you come back, don't cross over. I mean, that's awkward anyway.
Yep.
But
yep.
Just go in a comfortable range. If it starts to hurt, stop there.
Yep.
And always keep that foot neutral.
Very good points. You can use a towel roll under your heel if you're having trouble sliding, or the Bob and Brad knee glide works well under there too. So,
yep,
a couple different options. Now Mike's going to do some heel slides. He's going to pop his shoe off here.
Okay, so you can put this leg up if you want for some support, and you're just going to slide your heel towards your bottom. Don't go past 90 if you have those precautions. If you can't go that high, don't worry.
Yep.
Like, if you can just go here, that's fine. whatever is comfortable for your hip right now. If you have knee pain, just do what's comfortable for that as well.
The first couple weeks, you might just be able to go halfway. You know, weeks 2 to 4, you're probably, your heel's probably going to get closer to your butt. But, you know, don't worry about it too much. Number 6, I'm going to give you your pillow again.
Short arc quad. Okay. So, again, it's like straight. We're going to kick up, try to hold for 5 seconds if you can. And then relax back down.
Go down slowly because it's still strengthening.
Are you trying to tell me something?
Straight line. Yeah, go slower. Always, people usually put the coffee can under the knee. I always picture that with older people. You know that Folgers coffee can. You know what I'm saying, don't you?
I drink good coffee, so no, I don't know.
Hey, let's not make people mad. All right. Number 7. This one we were going kind of back and forth about. Be very careful, especially if you have posterior hip precautions with this one.
Yes, this is more of an anterior approach.
Yep.
It's called a hip flexion stretch.
Where did I put that towel?
So if you, I don't know what you did with it.
Here it is.
If you can reach with your hand, that's fine. This is more for the anterior approach because you're allowed to have your hip go past 90 degrees of flexion. I should specify what
degrees of bending.
So basically I'm doing is stretching up.
Yeah.
Like this. Yep. Obviously, if you have the posterior approach, this is a no-no.
No.
Don't
you can't
do this.
Break that 90-degree angle there.
This is my 90. I can't tell from my
angle. That's about 90.
This is about 90. Yep. So, yeah, if you're just stretching here, I mean, you'd be okay.
Yep,
but I'm not
good.
Really feeling a stretch. But if you have a anterior approach, you can try stretching out like this.
Mm-hmm. All right.
This is more of a holding one, 10, 15, 30 seconds, whatever you're comfortable with.
This is to gain a little range of motion, but restrictions still remain number one.
Yep.
Brad would be proud how he said that. He's always very anxious about not breaking restrictions. All right, let's get up. Let's sit up. Is that okay, sitting up?
No.
All right, seated long arc quads. So Mike showed you the short arc quad with the coffee can or the pillow folded up underneath your knee. This is long arc quad, so I'm sitting in a chair. Leaning back, not to break restrictions if I am posterior approach. And I'm just kicking out straight, holding it for a few seconds, back down slow, and then take a break. And let's do 10 reps of those.
It's going to be easier if you're in a chair and your feet can actually touch the ground.
Yep.
Gives it a little break. I'm kind of hanging right here. But
yep. And if that gets easy, hold it a little longer. Hold it for 5 seconds.
You can also alternate with your other leg for fun if you want. It's not going to hurt anything.
That's your idea of a good time?
Yeah.
All right. Number 9. Then we're going to go into some standing hip flexion. So this is my surgical side. So I'm just going to – can you pretend I have a walker here?
Sure.
All right. I'm just going to lift it up. No more than 90 degrees. This would be beyond 90. This is probably about 90.
So this 90 angle we're talking about is right here. I don't know if the camera can see that because you're angled funny.
Right here. The hip.
So do not go right there.
Yeah, he's thinking the knee.
I'm showing his knee too. His knee's at 90 as well.
Yep.
His 90 degree bend is right here. So if he was up, go beyond 90. Yeah, that's beyond 90.
Yep, that's a no-no. So
just go in a comfortable range.
And you probably won't even get close to 90 when you're doing that. I mean, in this stage. So I'm going to sit back down so they can. No, I'm not.
No, you're not. You're going to show the next exercise.
All right, you do squats.
Well, give me the chair.
Okay.
Okay, so you can hold out to your walker or a chair. These are just mini squats. Again, do not break your hip precautions of bending too far over. But if you just do little squats like this, this is fine. Just have something to hold on to, support. I mean, if you're a month out and you're not using an assistive device anymore and you feel comfortable, go ahead.
Yep.
Otherwise, most people, we have them do these in parallel bars in the therapy room.
Yep.
But a walker or a chair.
Did you say a chair behind you if you're very nervous about it?
Yeah, if you're an unsteady person, have a chair behind you. You can even have someone holding onto a gait belt if you want.
And get that butt, the cue we give everybody, almost everybody, get that butt back like you're sitting in the chair behind you. That's proper form.
Yeah, I'm just thinking about my butt dropping. I'm not. A lot of people will bend their knees like this.
Yeah, that doesn't do much for you.
And their heels come up and they do that. Just keep your heels flat. Try to push your butt back.
Yep.
That's all you're going to do.
And then Mike's going to show you calf and toe raises. Every, you know, this isn't your hip, but this is balance.
Yep.
And your calf, your calves get weak. Your anterior tib muscle gets weak. So
hold on again. Just go up on your toes, back on your heels. Mm-hmm. I would suggest doing both feet together. It gets a lot more challenging if you do one leg.
Yep.
But after hip replacement, just do both.
Sure.
If you can't go, you know, as high up on your feet, that's fine.
Yep. Yep.
Or if this bothers you, you know, you don't have to do it. It's just an optional one.
And when you do the toe raise, do a toe raise, Mike. don't fall backwards. Again, I repeat, safety is number one. Safety
no,
is fell. Number one. Should have been an actor. All right. I'm going to demonstrate a few here.
Okay.
All right. Then I'm going to do, this is actually number 11. This is just a hamstring stretch on a stool. We see people after hip replacement all the time. A lot of them get tightness in their hamstring. So
yep.
You just want to stretch it on a stool. If you want to give a little over pressure to stretch it out.
Notice him, Alex, sitting straight up. He's mm-hmm. not breaking hip precautions. If he were to bend forward,
yep.
now he's actually breaking his hip precautions if yep. you have the posterior approach.
Yep.
So just be aware of that. Do not bend forward.
Yep.
Keep it there.
Yep. So. All right. You can hold that, I would say, 30 seconds and do that a couple times, you know, three times a day. It's just a stretch. Nothing too difficult. And then again, the knee glide.
Probably keep it flat.
Flat, yeah.
We don't really want it at an incline yet because most of you are going to have the posterior approach and you'd be over 90 degrees of flexion.
Yep.
So nice. You can also use the towel if you would like,
yep.
If you don't have one of these.
Yep.
But these work well.
As you get like 3-4 weeks and you're doing the glide, you could do it 10-15 minutes if it's feeling good. So.
You can even try their Fit Glide. Mm-hmm. Get both legs working. That's
yep.
fine.
Yep.
We don't have it out here right now. But
yep. And then the last one. Continue your walking, you know, increase your walking distance. Your walking quality should be getting better as the weeks go on.
Yep, make sure work on focusing on landing on your heels when you're walking and rolling to your toes just
yep.
for a normal walking pattern. I'm exaggerating right now.
Yep.
Obviously, I don't walk like this, but work on that. If you're a lot of people when their hip is still weak, and they want to ditch the cane or ditch the walker too early,
yep.
they're going to start walking like this.
Yep, that's a very good point as well.
If you're walking like this, you ditched it too early and get the cane or the walker back. You want to be strong in your hips. You don't want to fatigue it early and be walking like this.
You're not doing yourselves any favors if you try getting rid of assistive device too early. That's for sure.
Yeah, so don't be ashamed that you're still using it. You'll get rid of it eventually. Just definitely use it for a while.
All right. Subscribe to us and
check out more videos related to the Total Hip Replacement Fitness Program at bobandbrad.com/programs.
Thank you.
Thanks.